Hello everybody. So in this video, I'll show you how to use two different screen recorders. One called Screencastify and the other OBS or Open Broadcaster Software Studio. So both of these are very different, meaning that Screencastify is an easy to use and in-browser kind of screen recorder, whereas OBS is an advanced screen recorder which has capabilities which are present in most paid softwares. So to show you the uses of these softwares, what I'll do is I will screen record using OBS when I teach you how to use Screencastify, and I will use Screencastify to screen record when I show you how to use OBS. So you can now get a visual comparison of how the end result will look if you screen record with one another. So who is this for? OBS is for anyone who plans to start a YouTube channel or who takes recording online lectures very seriously. You want to do some content for MOOCs, Swayam, etc. Screen recorder, on the other hand, is for someone who just wants to do some basic screen recording for his classes, not exceeding around 5 to 10 minutes. So in this video, I'll be showing you how to use a plugin for Chrome browser called as Screencastify to record your online lectures. So you can use this to record your screen or record your desktop. So go to your Chrome browser and in your search you can type Screencastify. So when you do that, the first option only it will show you as your Chrome browser plugins. Click that. So it will show you your Chrome browser plugins or extensions. So here it is showing Screencastify screen recorder. So more than 70 lakh users. So you just click add to Chrome and then click add the extension. So you can see first it will download the extension and then it will install it into your Chrome browser. So this will work on any operating system. It will work on your Windows PC, on your MacBooks, or even on a Chromebook. So once you are done, you will see this icon. So this is your icon which will be available on your Chrome tab. So on top you will see this icon as a Chrome extension. So the first time that you click, it will ask you to set up your Screencastify. So there are two ways that this screen recording app works. One is it can record your screen and download the video on your desktop. However, I recommend that you link it with your Google Drive, because then it gives you options of saving the videos in MP4 format. Otherwise, usually it saves it in a WebMD format, which is usually not compatible with most learning management systems. So I'll sign in. So it'll ask you if you want to allow it to access the Google Drive, and you have to click yes. So if you don't want to save it on your Google Drive, you would need not do this particular step. Then next step two, it will ask you permission for accessing your camera and microphone and drawing and annotation tools, all of which are necessary for your screen recording. Then click allow. So now this extension gets access to both your camera and microphone. Lastly, it asks you whether you're an educator, student, corporate user, government user. However, if you click anything also, the next set of options will remain the same. So here I will just choose educator and what level, education level. So since I teach medical college, so I'll choose college or university. So none of these selections will affect your end result, and you will get literally the same Chrome extension. So once it has set, it will redirect you to the Screencastify website. So how do we use it? There are two apps. One is the free and the paid app. The paid app is $49 per person per year. So if you like the free version, I will suggest that you can use this. The advantage of using this particular screen recorder over many others, such as your QuickTime that is available on Mac, or OBS or Camtasia that you can get on your Windows, or even Xbox Gameplay that is freely available on Windows, is that this in particular is very easy to use.
if you link it with your Google Drive, it does not save any of the videos on your desktop, and you can even do this basic editing like trimming on the browser itself. So you don't have to come out of the browser, your entire work can be done inside your Chrome browser. So the difference between this free and unlimited is literally they have the same features, except the fact that in free you can only record 5 minutes video at a time. So if you want more than 5 minutes video, you will have to choose the unlimited version. Since most of our educational videos can be split into small components of 5 minutes each, you can definitely try the free version. And it is very useful if you are already using Google Classroom, as you will see when I show you the features of this particular online recorder. So this is very similar to any other screen recorder. It can record your screen or it can record a particular window or a browser. So now I will show you by. So if you want to use this particular recorder, all you have to do is you have to click this icon that comes on your browser. So this is how you activate your Screencastify. So there are two ways to use it. Either you use your PowerPoint slides or your Google slides that are available in your Google Drive, and then I can literally record the browser. I don't have to record my entire desktop. So I'll show you. I'll just open one of my PowerPoints. I'll open it with Google Slides. Now if I want to record this presentation, what I can do is I can click this Screencastify. Then it gives me options such as you want to record your browser, you want to record your desktop, or you want to record your webcam only. So here most of the time you would either choose browser or desktop. So since I am playing my presentation inside my browser, I will choose browser or tab. The microphone, since I have connected a microphone, you will see it shows the option as internal microphone or blue snowball. So I can choose this external microphone that I have connected. To know if it's working or not, you can see this particular green light. So if this green line is moving as you're speaking, that means your microphone is working. So here I will choose my internal microphone, and there's an option of embedding your webcam also into your PowerPoint lecture. So if you choose that, it gives you an option of selecting the webcam. Since I have not attached any external webcam, it's giving me the option of my inbuilt webcam. Now you can click this show more options. So here there are options such as countdown 3 seconds. I highly recommend that you keep this. It lets you know when the recording is going to begin. Show drawing tools. This is if you want to use those drawing tools or annotations. And tab audio. So this you will keep it on only if you want to record the audio of your browser. For example, you want to play a YouTube video and you want to record the audio of the browser. Then I will click this as tab audio. Otherwise, I will click this as off, because the voice I want to hear is only from my microphone. So after this, I will choose record. Then to see more settings, you can click the settings button. So here you can choose the resolution. I would recommend that you use 720p. As for YouTube, 720p is more than enough, and frame rate of 30 frames per second. Auto stop, I'll keep it as off. So after this, all you have to do is choose the browser option. I want to record my desktop. So what I can choose is I'll choose Screencastify. I will choose desktop. And then I will choose record. So now Screencastify is recording my desktop. So here it will give me this window asking, do you want to record your entire screen or an application? If you want to restrict it, you can restrict it to Keynote, as this application is open. So I can click only my PowerPoint or Keynote application and click share, or you can choose the entire desktop. So now it shows my presentation. So I'll just scroll into the first slide and I'll click play. So now I can present the slide as, this is a video on examination of urine. So first we'll begin with the physical examination of urine and so on. So now I will exit this and then I will stop it. To stop it, you can either click the stop sharing here, or you can go back to your browser and click the plugin. So once you stop it, it will take some time for the Screencastify to process your video, and then it will show it in this particular window. So here you can see. So now what all can you do? So just using this basic browser, you can trim the video if trimming is all you need. So here I know that I'm starting the presentation. So I'm starting my presentation only here. So I can trim it by clicking the scissor icon and moving it to where I'm beginning the video. And if you want to trim the end, you can choose where you want it to end by moving the other scissor. So now only the area in between the two scissors will be saved in your video. So you click this and click trim. So the entire thing is happening inside your browser. So once you are done with this, there is an option of directly sharing your video either into your Google Classroom or publishing it with YouTube. So I'll click share to classroom, and now what it will do is it will open the Google Classroom account that is linked to this particular ID that I have linked with Screencastify Google Drive, and it will show me all the classes. Since there's only one class available, so it chooses only that class, and under that it asks me what I want to create. So as this is resource material, I'll click create material and I'll click go. I'll name it as, and I'll click post. And now I can go to my Google Classroom to view how it looks. So I'm just logging into my Google Classroom. So here you can see it's already directly been added, that you have posted a material using Screencastify. So I'll click it, and you can see that your video has been uploaded. So this is very useful for teachers who don't like to use many multiple cumbersome softwares to create an online lecture and only want to create short lectures for concepts. They don't intend to create multiple lectures for purpose of YouTube or longer lectures for e-modules, but who like to create small concept lectures. So it is very easy, as you don't have to install any software into your desktop. All you have to do is this particular extension, and the video is directly shared in your Google Drive. So if I go to my Google Drive, you can see that one folder called Castify has already been created, Screencastify. And if I double click it, it will show the multiple videos that I have created using Screencastify. You can use the Screencastify even if you want to teach something from a browser. So here I have opened a pathology website on tuberculosis, and I want to record this particular browser window as I'm teaching. So I can click the Screencastify icon, and I'll not choose the webcam here. I'll just choose the browser tab and click record. So here you can see that it gives me a countdown followed by my recording. So here when I record, I have this option of drawing. So I can choose the pen and I can choose the color. So I can tell regarding the disease. So I can say that's caused by tuberculosis. So this is one of the key findings to remember. And you can highlight things. And if you want to delete them, there's an eraser option also. And you can delete them individually, or you can click the erase and then click erase everything. So it'll erase the entire screen. So in between, if you choose that you want to add your webcam, you can even click the webcam in between, or you can switch it off. And when you decide that you want to stop the screen recording, all you have to do is click the same Screencastify icon and you can click stop. So once you stop, it will automatically open a new window inside which it will show your video. So this time, if you want to edit it, you can basic trimming can be done in the same window. However, if you want to do options like cutting portions of the video from in between, you can choose this open in editor option. Then you can see a Screencastify editor will open inside the browser. The advantage of this editor is it has slightly more options than what you get in the editor that appears immediately. So in this editor, the only option that you see is that you can trim the video. You can trim the two edges of the video. However, in their editor, you have slightly more features. However, this editor currently is free only for a 3-day trial. So I can choose the start 3-day trial. The one thing with Screencastify is that you need a reasonable internet speed. It does not work if your internet speed is slow. So it works very slowly if your internet. So as it's running on the browser, it predominantly uses your browser resources and your internet when you are doing features such as editing, as it's happening inside your Google Drive itself.
So the first time when it loads, it may take a few more seconds. So this editor, in addition to trimming, you can even clip some parts of your video from in between also. However, this is only free for 3 days, and after 3 days it is free only with the unlimited version, that is the one where you have to pay $49. Once it opens, it looks like this, where you can see the video and below you can see your timeline like you see in any video editor. So we'll do some basic things. I'll show you how to crop a video. So if you don't want your address bar or your address bar from your browser to appear, you can exclude that, and you can exclude the drawing annotation tools, and you can select this rectangle and click OK. So now you can see it has cropped the video itself. Next, if you want to click some parts from in between the video, so this is not available on your editor that appears in the beginning. So what you can do is you can select the point, click the scissor, select the second point and click the scissor again. So the scissor here is cut. So you can then you click the in between segment and click the dustbin icon or the delete icon. And now you have seen that in between portion is deleted. So if you want to save, you go to the top bar and you can see two options, either save to your Google Drive or download the MP4. So I'm clicking download MP4. You can give a name, crop and delete, and click download. So what it'll do is, first it'll process the video. Here it's converting the WebM file into an MP4 file. Once it is done, you can see automatically the download will appear in your Chrome browser. So once the download is complete, if I click the MP4 file, it'll open in any of your MP4 file readers. It can be VLC, LMedia or an MX player. So here you can see. So here you can see, now you can't see the address bar in the cropped file. And even that segment of where the annotations were there, I have reduced it significantly. So now if you want to see all your old screen recordings, click the Screencastify icon on your Chrome browser. And once it opens, all you have to do is click My Recordings. And here you can see all the recordings that you have done in your Screencastify. So there is no limit for this. There's only limit that each video can be a maximum of 5 minutes in the free account, but based on the size of your Google Drive, so until 15 GB, you can keep storing these videos in your Google Drive. If you want to download anything, you have to click the download button and you can choose export as MP4, and you can then download it.
So in this video, I'll be showing you how to use OBS. So to record this video, I'm using Screencastify, the uses of which I've explained in my previous video. So just to go to what is OBS, I'll just click OBS. So OBS is a very popular term for a YouTuber. So it's a very common software. So it is a very powerful software and it's an open source software, meaning that it is absolutely free. So there is no paid options in OBS. And literally all of its functions can be used by the free version. Its strengths are, it is there in, it's been released for Windows, Mac and Linux. And all the three versions are one, almost have the similar features and are very powerful. So how do you download it? So if you're on a Windows, you choose the Windows. If you're on a Mac, the Mac, and Linux, the Linux. So I will just click the Windows version. So once you choose that, automatically the download bar, progress bar, will begin. It's around 70 MB to download. So once you're done downloading and installing, this is how it will appear. I have already downloaded and installed it. So this is how the OBS icon will appear. So once you double click it, so you will get a black preview bar. So this is your window that you're selecting for recording. As of now, I've not selected anything. So first box is for scene. So already it would have created one scene. If you're working on more than one scene, so you can keep multiple. So if I've selected scene one as recording my display and my webcam, whereas scene two as only my display, so you can go back and forth as you're using this software. But to simplify it, as of now, I have not done anything. So this is how it would appear when you have just installed. There will be a scene already installed. So here you have to select your sources. Your audio usually automatically selects itself. So here you can see that it is selected my mic. So if you want to see which mic has been selected, you click the right side settings and you choose properties. So here you can see what has been selected as default. So I have an external mic connected, that is a Blue Snowball, and also I have the integrated mic. So here I will set it to the external mic and I'll choose OK. So here the audio that it's picking up from is from my external mic. Now to set the desktop, so click the plus button and then here in sources, to select your webcam, you can select your video capture device and click OK. So if you have attached an external webcam, you will be getting two options when you click this device. Since I don't have any attached external device, I'm only getting the webcam of my laptop. Then you can configure it. So you can either choose the quality of the video or the buffering, but I'll leave all that at default and click OK. So this is how my webcam window will appear. So now you can resize it and you can decide on which side you want in your recording. Next, after this, you can click plus and now you can choose your display source. So I can choose that I want to record my display. So usually if you have more than one display connected, you will get the options 1 and 2. But if you have no displays and just the monitor of your laptop, you will get this mirror effect. You're getting this mirror effect because you're recording your display and it keeps looping into itself. However, in the recording, you will not see this mirror effect. If you have more than one display connected, you will not be getting this mirror effect. But since my laptop is not connected to any other external display, for now, I'm getting this mirror effect. So now I'll drag this display capture below the video capture. So the video capture will appear on top and display will appear below. So now you can see that my recording will appear like this. It can see what is on my display and my webcam. So if you don't want your webcam, all you have to do is click that particular source. So click the video capture source and click this minus button. So it'll ask you if you want to remove your video capture, click yes. If you want to add it, just so now if you want to add your webcam, all you have to do is click plus and click video capture device and choose OK. And again, confirm it and again, rearrange it as to where you want it to appear. So this is how it will appear. So let me just set it again. So now you can see that I've set my webcam to the right bottom corner. So it does not end here. So you have advantages such as you can immediately even record a green screen. So if I right click this video capture device, I get option of filters. So in the filters, I can choose the filter called as. So here I can choose the effect filter as apply chroma key. So I'll click OK. So what chroma key does is it will remove the particular color. So for example, here I've given as apply chroma key blue. So you can see once I adjust this similarity, it will start removing the blue color from my background. So close. So now you can see that it appears as if this blue screen is not present behind me. So now I can click start record on the right hand side and now I can choose anything on my desktop. So I'll just choose PowerPoint and I will
start presenting this PowerPoint. So this is a presentation of presentation about the knee joint. So it is the largest superficial complex synovial joint, and it has two condylar lateral and median femorotibial, and I'll show you how it will appear on an OBS recording. So once I click stop recording, you can see that this OBS recording will get saved in your videos file inside your videos file of Windows. So all I have to do is double click it
and sign. So now I can choose anything on my desktop and I will PowerPoint. So this is a presentation of a presentation about the knee joint.
So here you could see that the green screen recording, which takes multiple editings, even when I am doing it on iMovie or Final Cut Pro or even softwares like Camtasia, is done so easily just using a single software. So I have not done any editing. All this is happening before you start recording your video. So if you want to remove your webcam, I've already shown you.
Thanks for watching. Click subscribe and click like if you like the video.